Well, except I learned the Gujarati script to write letters to my mother. But no, I translated once, but that's about it. Well, I was not. I can't. I was not taught to write in Swahili. And this was the only language I can write in. And you know, of course, it's political. I was brought up in partly in a colony or a British protectorate, and that's the politics. It's a global politics, and I think everyone is now learning English. So that's the world. I stopped fighting that battle. If you try what you're not comfortable with, it will show in the quality of the work. I don't know, I mean, there are writers, it's just a question of African writing does not have the exposure in Tanzania, does not have the development that is needed. I mean, in Tanzania, if there are no books published, similar quantity to the numbers published elsewhere, even compared to Kenya, then there's something wrong. I mean, it's not a question of and writing is not just having the intention to write, but to actually write completely in a form, you know, like in a formal sense. To have stories is different, or to write a story for newspapers, for example. Mkuki might have a story, but it's not really a developed story. It's a good start. But you have to write a story that at least we live in a world culture where there are more sophisticated stories. And you know, one easily can do that if one gives oneself a chance. You know? Or one has the encouragement from editors or magazines or readers. Who care about the writing. We have literature courses, so why can't people write literary type books instead of writing a short story by Vassanji, which is maybe easy. But it's not a story in a formal sense, it's an anecdote. And it's interesting because it tells you something interesting that happened or could have happened. But a story is a more developed form, right? Or at least has more thought in it. Needs writing, and all it needs is some media and some encouragement. And in a few years, you have it. I mean, in the 1960s, there was a thriving literary tradition in many countries in Africa. Right? It's when Mkuki appeared and Meja Mwangi appeared, and you know, there were so many people were coming out. All the major writers from Eastern Africa, or what people take, you know, Tawang Liyong, and you know, this was a culture that was there. And these people interacted with each other, they spoke with each other. That kind of a culture needs to be nurtured and created, and it can only be done by budding writers themselves. You just reach out to other people with a similar interest and start something and you keep going, you know, which is what these people did. You know. Language is not a problem, although it helps you. At some point, someone has to tell the world that this is what it is. There's some exciting writers in the Indian languages, and they also suffer the same problem. But there are some translators that tell the world that this is what the other writing from India is, and they realize that, you know, it needs to be told. You know, India is not just elephants and, you know, mendicants. You know, there are, you know, ordinary people living there, just like here.
How important is it for those writers to write in Hindi, for
It's crucial, right? because what you write, it's crucial that you keep writing in that. You know, unfortunately, even the young people now have decided that the English is their medium, and the Swahili itself is altering. But you know, that can be the new medium. You write what you're comfortable with. there's a lot of exciting possibilities. You know, it's just that the will and the inspiration have to be there. It's not a trivial work, you know. So of course it can be done.